Hello, my name is Michael Stolley, and I'm the first author of a recently accepted manuscript from Dave Massivus' lab entitled Depleting CD103 Positive Resident Memory T Cells in Vivo Reveals Immunostimulatory Functions in Oral Mucosa. Resident memory T cells, or TRM for short, are a subset of memory T cells that forgo systemic recirculation in exchange for durable residence within barrier non-lymphoid tissues, where they accelerate pathogen detection and clearance. The tissue-specific functions of TRM have begun to be well-characterized in many locations, including the intestines, skin, lungs, and urogenital mucosa. However, despite serving as an access point for pathogens infecting the intestines and lungs, the ontogeny and functional implications of TRM within the oral mucosa remain comparatively underexplored. We believe this knowledge gap reflects a lack of refined tools in animal models for interrogating T-cell biology in this complex, yet spatially limited, secretory, absorptive, and chemosensory tissue. We developed a systemic viral prime epitope pull, or VPEP, approach for generating preternaturally abundant and tractable CD8 TRM in the oral mucosa of mice. For this, T cells of a known antigen specificity were expanded in congenically mismatched host mice through a systemic viral infection and subsequently pulled into the oral mucosa 5 to 6 days later by swabbing the oral surfaces of anesthetized mice with cognate antigen dissolved in irritants. Our VPEP strategy yielded several hundred to thousands of oral TRM, which could be isolated for flow cytometric analysis. Moreover, VPEP elicited oral TRM were durably maintained in the mouth, broadly distributed throughout diverse oral structures, and largely expressed the tissue retention marker CD103. With this approach, oral TRM were transiently reactivated by reswabbing the oral mucosal surfaces of VPEP mice with cognate antigen dissolved in irritants. Reactivation elicited robust inflammation, including recruitment of circulating bystander memory T cells into the oral mucosa and transcriptional induction of several antiviral, interferon-stimulated, and chemotactic genes. Genes for chemoreception, mucosal sensation, saliva composition, and those implicated in oral inflammatory diseases, including periodontitis, were similarly invoked. We next developed an experimental approach for depleting CD103 expressing TRM in vivo. For this, wild-type CD8 T cells were transferred and expanded through VPEP in CD103-deficient host mice, making those transferred cells the only population capable of expressing CD103. Toxin-conjugated antibodies against CD103 were then used to efficiently eliminate CD103-expressing oral TRM, which comprised the majority of oral TRM after VPEP, while leaving circulating memory T cells intact. Employing this novel depletion system, which obviates off-target effects, we were able to demonstrate that CD103-expressing oral TRM, rather than their CD103-negative or circulating memory counterparts, were the critical catalysts of oral inflammation and transcriptional changes upon cognate antigen re-exposure in the oral mucosa. Collectively, our study introduces new methodologies for generating, studying, and in vivo depleting oral TRM, which may have broader implications for subset-specific immune cell depletion in other locations. Furthermore, we highlight the pro-inflammatory functions of oral TRM, which likely subvert oral viral infections, but may also contribute to undesired oral inflammation. Future work will interrogate the impact of oral TRM reactivation on salivary biology, chemoreception, and oral inflammatory conditions, including periodontitis. Thank you.